afternoon, all of you. I, Dr. Deepika Minhas, lecturer in Samhita and Siddhant department, welcomes you all. Today is the second last day of 42-day long Ayush Vibhodhini series. We are proud to bring such a massive and marvelous series to this wonderful end. I would like to thank our respected chairman, Sir Engineer Amarjeet Singh Walia, for believing in us. The series is not possible without the support and guidance of our principal, Dr. Meenakshi Nath ma'am, and vice principal, Dr. Mridu Sharma ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. We look forward to conduct such events in further too. Now, I request you, ma'am, to please welcome our guest of honor, Dr. Sanjeev Awasthi, sir. Welcome, sir, and over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Dr. Deepika. Good afternoon, everyone. And again, I welcome you all to this session of Ayush Vibhodhini Webinar Series 3. Ayush Vibhodhini Webinar Series is a daring dream for all of us. But with the blessings of Almighty, it has been going smoothly, and that too with a sense of satisfaction. This platform is very lucky, being shared by visionaries of Ayurveda as our keynote speakers and pillars of Ayurveda as guest of honors. Today also is such a blessed day as this session is graced with the magnificent presence of Dr. Sanjeev Awasthi, professor and HOD in the Department of Shalakya Tantra at Rajiv Gandhi Government Postgraduate Institute of Ayurveda, Pakrula. First of all, sincere regards and heartiest gratitude for accepting our invitation to witness this session, sir. And let me take the privilege to introduce our guest of honor, Dr. Sanjeev Awasthi. Dr. Sanjeev has completed his UG in 1987 from Government Ayurvedic College, Pakrula, and after his graduation, he started serving ailing humanity as AMO in Himachal Pradesh. Pursuing his passion for studies, he got selected in one of the most prestigious institutions of Ayurveda, Banaras Hindu University, and in the year 2000, he completed his PG. He joined his mother institution as a teaching faculty. Sir has guided and co-guided more than 20 students. Besides being a delegate in many CMEs and ROTPs, he has delivered many lectures in many CMEs and ROTPs. He has published several research papers in various national and international journals. Sir is one of the most cool, calm, friendly, and kind-hearted person I have ever met. His aura is magnetic and charismatic. The length and depth of his experience is unmatched. The bonding he shares with his students is really marvelous. And myself and Dr. Vinod, our keynote speaker for today, are a first-hand witness to the kind of personality he is. Call it a coincidence or a brilliant play of destiny that the very first student Sir co-guided for PG was none other than Dr. Vinod himself, and the very first student Sir guided by Sir was myself. God indeed is kind enough that we share the same platform today after so many years. Dr. Vinod would agree with me that we are immensely lucky to have had Sir as our guide and co-guide during our PG. I cannot begin to enumerate Sir's contributions in numerous careers like mine. I am very thankful to you, Sir, for this privileged opportunity. Now I request you, Sir, to please bless us with your words of enlightenment. Over to you, Sir.
Thank you, Dr. Meenakshi, for these very nice words. I am overwhelmed by your words, and I am very happy that both my students, Dr. Vinod Jain and Dr. Meenakshi Nath, are present here and organizing a webinar. My best wishes to all of you, including your team. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your words, for your wise words, for enlightenment of we all people. Now I welcome our keynote speaker for today, Dr. Vinod Jain, with his unique topic, medical astrology and shalaka tantra procedures. We all know Ayurveda and astrology, they go side by side. Our acharyas have used astrology while collection of medicines, manufacturing of medicine, or for starting of the medicine, etc., etc. We should also follow the same path, and Dr. Jain's topic will certainly be a curtain raiser for this start. So I am very thankful to Dr. Jain for sharing such a different but useful topic with us. Thank you, Dr. Jain. Thank you, Dr. Sanjeev. Over to you, Dr. Deepika.
Thank you, Dr. Meenakshi. First of all, I go in the feet of Lord Dhanvantri. Om Dhanvantraya Namah. Then I go to all the nine planets.
Hello, Dr. Jain.
Yes,
sorry to interrupt you, but we have to introduce you also. So please.
You have given a slight introduction of mine or not?
I have given, but we want you to introduce in an elaborate way.
Okay. I, Dr. Vinojan, presently in the Dhanvantri Ayurvedic.
Hello? Dr. Jain, yes, we will introduce you.
Okay,
doctor. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Meenakshi ma'am, and thanks to our respected Dr. Sanjeev Awasthi sir for your blessings and for your valuable presence. Thank you, sir. Now I would like to introduce and welcome today's keynote speaker, Dr. Vinod Jain sir. Sir has completed his PG Sir has completed his UG from Government Ayurvedic College, Patiala in 1981, and in 2003 he completed his PG from Rajiv Gandhi Government Ayurvedic College, Uprola. In 1991, after his UG, sir has served in Dhanvantri Ayurvedic College, Chandigarh. After his PG, he has joined the same institution. In 2008, sir has joined Government Ayurvedic College, Uprola for a short span of time. In 2004, sir again joined Dhanvantri Ayurvedic College, Chandigarh. He is also an expert and keen observer of astrology. So he includes it in his treatment also. So now I request sir to please present his unique topic, medical astrology and easy shalakya procedures in modern times. Over to you, sir. And thank you, sir, for joining us.
Thank you. First of all, I go to Lord Dhanvantri, Om Dhanvantraya Namah, then to the nine planets which are governing whole of our universe, Om Brahma Murari Tripurantakari Bhanu Shashi Bhumi Suta Budhascha Gurushcha Shukra Shani Rahu Ketva Sarve Graha Shantikara Bhantu. Then I go to my parents, then to my Gurujan, and I am lucky that Dr. Sanjeev Awasthi, who taught me in PG, is here. So accept my reverence, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Vinod Jain.
Thank you, sir. Now I start with this unique topic, though this topic is originally with Ayurveda, or astrology was with Ayurveda in the ancient times, because our rishis were masters of this subject. But later on, due to so many reasons, this aspect of astrology got dissociated from Ayurveda, and later on Vaidyas did not prescribe this Jyotish in as a part of treatment. But many Vaidyas were there who used Jyotish for the treatment of patients. All you know, Ayurveda, first thing which is written in Ayurveda is Yatha Pinde Tatha Brahmande. So as is universe, same is our body, and our body is controlled by the movements, the distance, the situation of all the planets. So all the humors in our body are influenced by the movement and their size, their distance. So whatever is there in the body is influenced by the planets. You all know Sun, Moon and all planets affect human body according to their nature and humors present in the body, similar to them due to law of affinity, because each planet has own characteristics, and all those characteristics are influenced in our body, which later affect in the development and all the functioning of the body. Because of this, at the time of birth, what is the position of the planets? What is the distance of planet, or what is the movement of planet? Sometimes planets are fast, sometimes planets are slow. So each and every movement affect at the time of birth. Before birth, even at the time of inception, that is the starting life of fetus, is also influenced by the planets. That is, in the pregnancy itself, the situation of the mind of male and female is influenced by the planet, and so the union of fetus or sperm and ova is also influenced by the planets. Mental state is very important at that time of inception. So their effect in the all the 9 months of pregnancy is also there. Each planet affects in each month to its effect or position in the universe. For example, in the first month, Sun is the influencer. In the second month, Moon is the influencer. Same way in the fourth month also, when heart is being formed, again Sun affects. So whenever there is development of the fetus, Jupiter affects. So whenever there is a formation of bone starts, Sun and Mars influence in the fetal life. So planets, at the same time, planets also affect our climate and also humors of the body. This is applicable to the body also. Domination of Vata, Pitta and Kapha is affected by the nature of the planet. So whatever planet is influencing the body in the fetal life and at the time of birth, that humor is influenced or is dominant in that person throughout one's life. This causes changes at the cellular level. So for example, in summers, due to the heat of the sun, the pressure in the atmosphere is decreased. The cellular body expands, causing diminishing in the functioning. So that is why in summers we call it as a visarga kal. Same way in the winters, the distance between earth and sun is too much. Winters, the increase in kapha is caused. Vata dominates in summer, and Pitta dominates in the mid season, and Kapha dominates in the winter season. This planetary movement causes movement of blood, secretion of humors, digestion power, sexual activity, and in accordance with the planet position in the horoscope, same is applicable to the person involved. All the at the time of pregnancy, planetary position effect at the chromosomal and this ribosomal level. Whole genetic material, as it is composed of 5 elements, that is Akash, Vayu, Agni, Jal and Prithvi. All the 5 elements form such a shape according to the position of the planets in the universe. So that is why each human is different according to the genetic material under the influence of the planets. Now I start with the effect of planets. First is Sun. Sun is a fiery planet, medium built. That is, the person with the sun's dominance will having a medium built, dry, represent I, then right eye in males and left eye in females. It causes strengthening of the bones. It affects head, heart, vitality, and if malefic, will cause diseases of parts involved, especially heart, eye, head, bone. It also influences fevers, syncope, and then skin disorders. For example, dry skin diseases are caused by influence of the sun. Next planet is Moon. It is a watery planet. Person affected by Moon are of tall size. It affects right eye in females and left eye in males. It affects chest, breast, lungs, brain, abdomen, bladder, blood, especially the liquid part of the blood, and mind. The most important planet influencing mind is Moon. Then comes diseases caused by Moon. All the cough rogue are due to malefic Moon, or diseases as ascites, mouth ulcers, diseases of nose, jaundice, weak digestion, diarrhea, leucorrhea, then epilepsy, and again vata shleshmik jwar is also caused by the effect of the Moon. Then comes Mars, fiery planet, small, dry. It affects skull, digestion, ligaments, then tendons, genitals, bone marrow, muscles, strength of the body, and burning sensation. If malefic, it causes diseases like blood disorders, hypertension, boils, inflammations, trauma, bleeding disorders, then vata pitta vikar. Then comes Mercury. It is an earthy planet. It is one of the most important planet because it causes association with all the planets. So every planet having any particular disease can be influenced by the involvement of Mercury. Mercury is earthy, medium built, watery. It affects tongue, voice, larynx, trachea, forebrain, nerves, and it, when malefic, it causes syncope, hysteria, mental disorders, vertigo, viral fevers, then bacterial fevers, diseases like sangrahini, grahini vikar, diseases of the throat, nasika, and diseases of the ligaments, or also disease of the nerves. Then comes Jupiter. This is Akashiya planet, that is, it controls space. It is medium built, watery. It controls fats, it controls semen, it controls the abdomen, liver, and tridosh disorders. When malefic, it causes diseases of the stomach, marrow diseases, liver disorders, obesity, then vayu vikar. We call it as vata vikar. Sometimes it also causes diseases of the ears and brain. Then comes Venus. Venus is a watery planet, medium built. It controls genitals, reproductive organs. Then it controls beauty of the eyes, that is, presentation of the eyes in universe. Or we say that a person has beautiful eyes. That is due to the effect of the Venus. It also controls chin. Then, if malefic, it causes diseases like sexually transmitted diseases, intoxications, then विश्व जन्य विकार डिजीजेस लाइक उपदंश प्रमेह मधुमेह एंड कफज विकार. देन कम्स सैटर्न. इट कंट्रोल्स एयर टॉल ड्राई प्लैनेट. इट कंट्रोल्स फीट नीज नर्व्स एंड वात. इट कॉजेस डिजीजेस ऑफ वाता especially joint diseases, pain, paralysis, insanity, cough, asthma, trauma, then mental irritations, or we call it as asantosh. Then sometimes diseases which cause lethargy are also controlled, affected by Saturn. Then comes Rahu. Controlling Vat, medium built, it controls brain, blood, skin. Diseases are caused like epidemic diseases, Chetak. It also causes worm diseases, epilepsy, snake bite, or leprosy or cancer. Then comes Ketu. It is a Vatic planet. It controls blood, skin, and diseases are caused as laziness, trauma, and skin disorders. Next, please. Next slide. Yes, next. Yes, Dr. Meenakshi.
Hello.
इधर से move नहीं होगा. Yes, Meenakshi, next slide.
Hello,
next slide नहीं move कर रहे हैं.
हम तो move कर रहे हैं डॉक्टर. हम बोल रहे हैं कि उस effects of nakshatras वाली हमने show करी हुई है ना, वो आपको नहीं दिख
रही? नहीं, इधर तो नहीं आई अभी. Next planets के बाद
बारिश हो रही है ना, net की problem आ रही है, बारिश हो रही है ना इधर. तो आप वहाँ से होते ही गए, तो फिर आप ऐसे ही बोलते रहो.
मैं फिर
देखते रहेंगे सब.
ठीक है, ठीक है. Yes, next is the effect of nakshatras. There are 27 nakshatras in the universe. If we name, it will take time. Ashwani, Bharani, Kritika, Rohini, Mrikshira, Aridra, Punarvasu, Pushya, Ashlesha. This is one set of nakshatras. Second set is Magha, Purva, Phaguni, Uttara, Phaguni, Hasta, Chitra, Swati, Vishakha, Anuradha, Jyeshtha. Then third set is मूला पूर्वाषाढ़ा उत्तराषाढ़ा श्रवण धनिष्ठ शत भिषज एंड देन पूर्व भाद्रपद उत्तर भाद्रपद एंड रेवती एंड टुडे एट दिस टाइम व्हेन आई एम स्पीकिंग इट इज द रेवती नक्षत्र व्हिच इज बीइंग ट्रांजिटेड बाय मून. सो एवरी नक्षत्र हैज इट्स ओन टाइप शेप इन्फ्लुएंस ओवर द बॉडी. For example, I won't be dealing with all the nakshatras. I just give you one example. For example, this Ashwini nakshatra, it is controlled by planet Ketu. It causes diseases like paralysis of the lower extremities. It causes insomnia, and sometimes it causes dementia. The effect of nakshatra is in such a way when a disease occurs. Supposingly a person comes and says that he fall ill yesterday and yesterday was Ashwini nakshatra. So we will see that diseases are according to the influence of the planet Ketu. Because Ashwini nakshatra, Magha nakshatra and Mula nakshatra are ruled by Ketu. Bharani, Purva Phagani, Purva Shada by Venus. Kritika, Uttara Phagani, Uttara Shada by Sun. Rohini, Hasta and Shravan are ruled by Moon. Mrikshira, Chitra, Dhanishtha are ruled by Mars. Aridra, Swati, Shat, Bhishaj ruled by Rahu. Unvasu, Vishakha, Purv Bhadrapad ruled by Jupiter. Pushya, Anuradha, Uttar Bhadrapad by Saturn. And Ashlesha, Jyeshtha and Revati are ruled by planet Mercury. So if a disease occurs, the lord of that nakshatra also influences the disease. Secondly, by knowing the nakshatra in which disease occur, we can say that a disease will last for this many days, or the effect of the disease will be of these many days. For example, a person comes and the disease is caused in Magha nakshatra. Magha nakshatra is ruled by planet Ketu. The disease will last for 20 days, 30 days, or sometimes 45 days, depending upon the malefic influence of all the planets. If malefic influence is less, the disease will last for 20 days. If malefic influence, that is, malefic planets are operable at that particular moment, then disease will minimum rule for 45 days. By this, we can decide the fate of the disease, the medicine to be given, because we know planetary movement at that time and causing nakshatra, disease causing nakshatra. Next, please. Next is rashis. We call it as signs. There are 12 signs in the universe. The signs are Aries, called Mesh, Taurus, called Vrish, Gemini, Mithun, Cancer, Kirk, Leo, Singha, Virgo, Kanya, Libra, Tula, Scorpio, Vrishchak, Sagittarius, Dhanu, Capricorn, Makar, Aquarius, Kumbh, Pisces, Meena. Now, as you are seeing over the slide, that each sign controls different parts of the body. For example, Aries controls, or Aries is located in our brain, forehead and hair. So when we see a chart and there is some malefic influence over the Aries, we can easily see that disease is related with brain or forehead or hair, or any malefic influence is there in the Leo, then disease is in the heart, stomach or liver or spleen. This way we can know the type of the disease or disease causing sign, because we know the lord of the sign. In this, Aries and Scorpio, they are ruled by Mars. Taurus and Libra ruled by Venus. Gemini and Virgo ruled by Mercury. Cancer ruled by Moon. Leo ruled by Sun. Sagittarius and Pisces ruled by Jupiter. Capricorn and Aquarius, they are ruled by Saturn. So any malefic influence in any sign, we can see that this disease is related to this part of the body and disease causing planet, or sometimes disease controlling planet or curing planet is the lord of that sign. Next. Now we have seen that parts controlled by different signs. Next is sign and diseases caused. So Aries, the most diseases caused due to effect, malefic effect over the Aries are netra, mukhrog, medorog, shirashul, unmad, and anidra. Taurus, upper respiratory tract diseases, then ENT diseases. Gemini, raktavikar, shwas rog, or cervical spondylosis. Cancer, heart, lungs, because moon controls rakt, it's a liquid part. So diseases of rakt also occur due to the influence of moon. Then Leo, diseases of the stomach, obesity, and vatic as well as pathic disorders. Then Virgo, diseases of the liver, kidney, spleen, indigestion, and backache. Then Libra, urinary bladder, diabetes, leucorrhea, difficulty in urination, or sometimes sexual disorders. Scorpio, diseases of the anus, penis, fistula, piles, and STDs. Sagittarius, seasonal diseases, especially allergic disorders. Fractures, bone marrow diseases, then blood diseases, especially the diseases of the WBCs. Capricorn, Vatrog, skin, blood pressure, and diseases due to cold. Aquarius, ascites, mental diseases, and spasmodic disorders. Spasmodic disorders occurring anywhere in the body are controlled by Aquarius sign. Then Pisces, allergies, skin, rheumatic disorders, gout, and eye diseases. Next, next, for the location of the disease, we have different charts in astrology, but the most important chart is the natal chart. In this natal chart, we have 12 houses. Each house has, already discussed, effect over the body parts and disease causing, or disease which will be related to that particular part or house. When we try to pinpoint the disease, each house, which is 30 degree, is divided into three, that is 10 degree each part. This 10 degree part is called as Dreshkan. When we see whole of the chart, Dreshkan, that is 30 degree, is too much. We cannot locate the disease or pinpoint the disease. But when we see Dreshkan, we divide the body or each part of the body into three parts to locate the disease. It is first to 10 degree, it is first Dreshkan. 10 to 20 degree, it is second Dreshkan. And 20 to 30 degree, it is third Dreshkan. For example, a person comes to us and at the time of appearance, that is appearance of the disease, the third Dreshkan of any sign, especially the first sign, is being ruled. First Dreshkan, it will be Shir, but in the third Dreshkan, the person will definitely having the disorder of the this pelvic region. We call it as Vasti. And if the disease in the second Dreshkan, or third Dreshkan of the second house, then it will be affecting the genital parts, that is Ling. Or if it is in the 12th segment of that third Dreshkan, then it will be affecting anal part. This way we can locate the disease, that where the disease is or from where the disease originated, because we are seeing natal chart and Dreshkan. So we can point that disease which is affecting the eyes, basically it originated from anal parts. Some disorder in the anal part is causing disease in the eye. This way, with the help of Dreshkan, we can relate the appearance of the disease. Now, next is factors influencing planets which cause disease. In this astrology, the most important house which causes disease is the sixth house, because this sixth house is the disease causing house or related to the disease. The strength of this house will tell us that disease is a dangerous one or disease is easily curable, because in this house, whatever the planet comes will be able to cause disease. If the planet in that house is friendly to the sign which is being occupied in the sixth house, the disease will be of low intensity. But if there are enemy house, enemy planet, then the disease will be dangerous one. After sixth house, this is the important house to know the type of the disease, effect of the disease. Then comes the 12th and 8th house. If 8th house is strong or it is occupied by malefic planets, the disease will be of unknown origin, one thing. Secondly, disease will be of purva karma, that is effect of the purva karma. If 12th house is weak or 12th house is strong, weak means the person will be hospitalized for longer period. And if 12th house is strong, then person will be in the hospital for a shorter period, but with the severity of the disease will be more. Then 6th house tells us about the disease. Then planets in the 6th house. If the planets in the 6th house are favorable or friendly to the 6th house sign, the disease will be of low intensity. If the planets in the 6th house are inimical, or that is they are enemy to the sign occupied in the 6th house, then the disease will be dangerous one. Then planets and house, that is 1st house, and planets or lord of the 1st house, where they are. Planets in the 1st house, because 1st house tells us about the whole of the body. It controls the head, but at the same time, it controls the whole of the physical strength of the person. If a 1st house is weak, the person will be of a weak stature. If 1st house is strong, or the planets in the 1st house, they are friendly to the 1st house and they are strong in 1st house, then whatever the disease may be, the person will not be affected by the disease too much, or the immunity of the person will be very strong. If 1st house is strong, immunity will be strong. If 6th house is strong, then immunity will be weak. Then planets in ascending and descending order. Descending means the planets are going from their highest point to the lowest point. Planets in ascending disorder, they are going from their lowest point to the highest point. So if a planet is in descending order, the planet is considered to be weak, and planet in ascending disorder is descending order, then it is considered to be strong. So disease causing planet should always be in a descending order. That is, it is getting weak and weak. So disease will get weak and weak with the passage of time. So there is another division in the astrology that is called as 60th division or Shashtiyamsha. In this 60th division, each planet, each house is divided into 60 part. That is, A sign is having 30 degree. Each house having dimensions of 30 degree. But each degree is again divided into two parts. So it comes 60th division or 60 parts in a one house. In this 60th division, there are 60 points, which are 30 points are favorable one and 30 points are malefic, that is, they are against. This classification of 60 division depends upon the sign. If the sign is 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, and 11, counting is from first point to 60th point. And if the planet, the house is 2nd, 4th, 6th, 8th, 10th, and 12th, then counting is from 60th to 1st. Of the 30 malefic points, 30 benefic points. So at the time of the disease, or the person whose natal horoscope, though the planet is in a very good house, but is occupying the malefic malefic 30th 60th division, then whatever disease is caused, or if planet is malefic and disease causing planet, the disease will be dangerous one or difficult to cure. So by knowing that 60th division of each planet in the horoscope, we can calculate that disease will be of longer duration or shorter duration. Then malefic influence over the planet. In the horoscope, second house and seventh house, they are considered as marka houses. That is, whatever disease is caused due to the planet of these two houses is having killing tendencies, that is marka tendencies. The planets in third and sixth, they are disease causing planet. In eighth house, the planets are of a very serious nature. Then they can also cause death. The planets in 12th house, they can cause hospitalization. So at the time of disease, which house is causing effect over the native, we can calculate accordingly which type of disease is. Then Arishta and Markatva. You all know Arishta. Arishta means some malefic influences over the body. So if there are Arishta in the horoscope, then the person's life as well as the person's strength or immunity will be hampered and person will be weak. So by calculating Arishta from the natal horoscope, Markatva, that is death inflicting influence of the planets in the horoscope, we can calculate diseases, that what type of diseases the person will suffer from. Next. Now, in the last part, when a person suffers from disease, we can divide in two parts, that is Sahaj or Janamjat, other is Agantik, Agantuk, and Traumatic. Sahaj and Janamjat can be of two types, Sharirik and Mansik. Sahaj diseases are Purva Janamakrit, or due to karmas of parents. Generally, this type of diseases are asadhya or difficult to cure. And these diseases are generally related to the eighth house of astrology. So whatever congenital disorders or the disorders which are due to influence of the genetic material, they are called as Sahaj diseases. Examples of Sahaj diseases are the diseases which are caused as congenital blindness, deafness, kubuchita, kyphosis, or lame or langdapan. These are sahaj diseases. Then sahaj diseases, they are difficult to cure, but with the help of propitiation of planet, that is called as puja, or dharan of money, because each planet is controlled by one ratna. For example, the Jupiter, it is controlled by Pukhraj, or Jupiter influence can be increased or decreased by wearing or not wearing Pukhraj. So if in the horoscope some congenital disease is due to influence of the Jupiter, we can propitiate, or we can recite the mantras which can pacify Jupiter effect. So disease can be controlled, not cured, because it is a congenital disease. Then there are another type of diseases are agantuk, which are again sharirik and mansik, or they are also drisht nimittaj or adrisht nimittaj. Drisht nimittaj diseases are, for example, epidemics, diseases related to sixth house, where we know the reason, because disease causing planet is there, sign is there, and we can know that this type of diseases or disease cause is this. We can control these diseases or treat these diseases. These are generally called as sadhya rog. Then adrisht nimittaj. Adrisht nimittaj diseases are due to badhaka planet. Badhaka planet is the planet lord of 11th house, lord of 9th house, or lord of 7th house, according to the rising sign in the ascendant. For movable sign, that is Aries or Cancer, Aries or Leo, Cancer, the disease is generally of adrisht nimittaj, or they are badhaka planet. For Libra ascendant, the badhaka planet will be of the 9th house. For dual sign, that is 3, 6, 9 and 12, the badhaka planet will be of 7th house. These badhaka planet, that is, they are obstructing planets, and they cause diseases which are of unknown cause. We cannot see the cause. So diseases are like, which are affecting the dhatu in the body. Dhatu janya, like raktavikar, charmavikar, asthivikar, or the diseases which are due to inborn effect in the sapta dhatu. Then comes effect of some diseases which are due to which type of planets, or which type of humors. For example, Tridoshaj. Tridoshaj, the most important planet is Mercury. Diseases are amvat, paralysis, jaundice, skin disorders, mental diseases, and hysteria epilepsy. The Mercury's involvement with other planets will result in such diseases. For example, if Mercury is under the malefic influence of Jupiter, then jaundice will be caused. If Mercury is under the influence of Moon and Mars, then amvat will cause paralysis. Saturn is the responsible planet. Mental disorders, Moon is the responsible planet. Next. So this way we can correlate different humors of the body, that is Vata, Pitta, Kapha, and planets, and know the type of disease, result of the disease, and treatment of the disease by propitiating that particular planet. Now I have prepared a slideshow or video for this easy Nasya Karma, easy Akshi Tarpan, easy Karna Puran at one go. This, in this fast era, that is we have no time or we cannot devote much time for all the cure of eye diseases, ear diseases. ये आपको वीडियो दिख रही है अभी स्लाइड दिख रही है हेलो स्लाइड दिख रही है
यस यस सर
I have prepared a small video clip about easy Shalakya procedure, which can be done by a patient at home in this fast-moving world. So we do not need any hospitalization. Arun. Isko.
So that patient's mind, body, and the local parts are intelligent.
Yes, sir. Second, sir.
Our video is not visible.
Any ghee or oil can be applied. अगर हम बात ही डालेंगे तो अंदर का यह प्रॉब्लम होने से दवाई अंदर तो भीतर नहीं जाएगी Thank you.
In this way, we can do all the three karmas, Akshitarpan, Karnpuran, as well as Nasyakarm, at one go. Hello.
धन्यवाद जैन सर, आपका ये जो टॉपिक आयुर्वेद और एस्ट्रोलॉजी का कॉम्बिनेशन था, बहुत बहुत ज्यादा सभी डेलीगेट्स को फ्रूटफुल रहा होगा और हम सबके लिए गागर में सागर भरने जैसा था। धन्यवाद सर, धन्यवाद। और
थैंक यू वेरी मच डॉक्टर संजीव सर, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद सर, आपने अपने बहुमूल्य समय में से हमारे लिए अपना समय निकाला, हम बहुत धन्यवादी हैं आपके। थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू डॉक्टर जैन।
मैडम, प्रिंसिपल मैडम, स्मॉल रिक्वेस्ट, ओनली वन क्वेश्चन।
ओके 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 सर, गो फॉर इट।
ओके सर, देयर आर नवग्रहस आर वर देयर, नाउ रीसेंट फाइंडिंग्स देयर इज अष्टग्रह सेस, हाउ वी एक्सेप्ट दिस? Pluto is exempted. Can we accept, sir? Hello? Speaker, sir?
Jain, sir, ab main aapko please unmute kar lijiye.
सर,
हाँ, यस सर,
यस सर,
हाँ जी
सर, एर्लियर आवर हिस्ट्री सेज नवग्रहस, द रीसेंट फाइंडिंग्स एंड रिसर्चेस टोल्ड दैट प्लूटो इज एग्जेम्प्टेड, इज नाउ अष्टग्रह, कैन वी एक्सेप्ट सर?
नो नो, इन फैक्ट इन एंशिएंट आवर ओन एस्ट्रोलॉजी वी डू नॉट कंसीडर प्लूटो एज अ प्लैनेट, वी आर ओनली कंसीडरिंग सेवन प्लैनेट्स ऑल यू नो plus Rahu and Ketu. Rahu and Ketu are Chaya Grahas, but their influence is equal as to other nine planets. If you are saying like Pluto to be included or not, then Moon is not a planet, but our ancient astrology considers Moon as planet. We are only considering our Indian astrology, none other astrology. I hope you understand.
Sir, one more question, sir. Sukumara, yes. Asura Kumara, which planet is influenced on that, sir?
Pardon, please repeat.
Sukumara, Asura Kumara, which planet is influences these two people?
No, Sukumara is a Mercury.
Okay. Sir, in all arches cases and genital disorder cases, you told the Vrichika Rasi suffers more, you told. That in many cases nowadays, due to the usage of the junk foods and packed foods, many people are getting the arches. Is it correlate to the our ancient science at present situation?
Yeah, we can correlate is, as Rahu is the causative planet in this modern era. Because Rahu is the most you know, active planet. We are communicating with each other at this moment due to the impact of Rahu. This technology is under the influence of the Rahu. So junk food and all these things are continuous computer work. We are, devoting too much time, screen time. All are coming under the influence of Rahu. That is why such type of diseases are there.
Sir, as you told, Mercury influences the epilepsy and all these things. What about the Shishupakshaghata in a congenital related disease? In some cases...
Repeat.
Sir, you told that Mercury influences the epilepsy and other disorders. I found one case, Shishupakshaghata from the congenital life factor. So that was star was not in Mercury related.
You know, Mercury is the planet which is controlling nerves, one thing. Second, the Mercury can influence each and every planet. Third thing, if Mercury is under the influence of Saturn or Ketu is the planet which controls worms. And Ketu also is the planet which controls segregation, that is division. So whenever there is any divisive, operation in the brain, that is divisive, that is cutting the currents. Currents means the impulse of the nerves. So that is controlled by Ketu. If Mercury is located in a bad house, at the same time, Moon is also influenced by Saturn, by Rahu or Ketu, then epilepsy-like diseases can occur. Epilepsy is one example. At the same time, you can divide so many mental diseases, for example, schizophrenia, insomnia, due to the influence of different planets. So in that case, you have to see the horoscope, location of the planet. As I told, that Shashti Amsha is most important. So Shashti Amsha, though the house is very good, say it is ninth house, which is Bhagyasthan, but the planet there is Mercury, and in a very bad Shashti Amsha, the person having Mercury in bad Shashti Amsha in ninth house, at the same time that Mercury is influenced by Ketu and Saturn. Ketu and Saturn are also influencing Moon, which is controlling mind. The person can suffer from epilepsy. I hope you understand.
Sir, okay, thank you. Sir, why people are fearing about Rahu and Ketu? Why people are fearing and hearing the sound of Rahu and Ketu?
Why people are?
Fearing, on listening the words fearing Rahu and Ketu.
Acha, fearing?
Yes.
Sir, with the due apology to all the planets, every planet has bad effects. Every planet has good effects. A person controlled by Rahu can, attain great heights if Rahu is benefic. At the same time, if Jupiter is in a malefic house, under the malefic influence, whatsoever may be the appearance of a person, whatsoever may be the financial status of the person, but if Jupiter is bad, the person will be having a diseases which can down his vitality or her vitality. So every planet is good, every planet is bad.
Okay. Thank you, doctor. Thank you. Thank you, welcome. Sir.
Welcome.
सबसे पहले डॉक्टर ए सूर्य नारायण जी का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद जिन्होंने इतने अच्छे क्वेश्चन पूछे और दूसरा धन्यवाद विनोद सर का जिन्होंने बहुत बहुत अच्छे से सबके क्वेरी को सॉल्व किया धन्यवाद सर और लास्ट बट नॉट द लीस्ट संजीव अवस्थी सर धन्यवाद बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद सर आपका आज मैंने अपने गुरु के दर्शन किए धन्यवाद सर
नमस्कार गुरु जी
थैंक यू
आपके दो और शिष्य भी बैठे मेरे पास
हाँ मुझे याद है उनकी
रिचा और अरुण
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद
धन्यवाद सर
थैंक यू वेरी मच सर बहुत बहुत थैंक यू सर, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद. थैंक यू डॉक्टर जैन, थैंक यू वेरी मच.
वेलकम डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी, थैंक यू.
थैंक यू, थैंक यू, थैंक यू वेरी मच सर. ओके सर.